seen anything about such a good day. Watching over, we want to keep it safe. We thank you for our service this morning, Lord. We pray, Father, that you'll have your way here tonight. Give our heart, Lord. Help us do our part, Lord. Praise you. Just give you all glory, Lord, for we know there's nothing else. We ask you to be with the choir of the saint, Lord, and Brother David did service. And the man brings word, we pray. The heart of the touch, Lord, help us grow closer and be faithful. These things we ask you in your precious name.
Amen. Just mind the Lord, Steve. That song picked out?
Yeah, but we have plenty, so she can play. 653.
653.
Huh? She's calling. Yeah, calling.
Well, bless y'all, everybody. Father, we thank you, Lord, as we come before you this evening, give you all praise. Thank you, Lord, for the wonderful day that you have given us, Lord. And Father, as we come to take up the offering tonight, Lord, we do ask, Lord, that you'll bless this offering for the building of thy kingdom. We pray, Lord, that you'll bless those that have to give and those that don't, Father, we pray. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness. We love you, Lord. Have your way tonight in the service, in Jesus' name. We ask you all.
Amen. Song, Ray, come before the Lord in prayer, sing. Does anybody got a special prayer request on your heart?
Remember, Mark,
we can't serve you on the first place. Anybody read the request? Anyone else?
Remember Mitch tonight, he's not feeling well.
Yeah, remember that request.
Remember a friend we have down in Kentucky, I talked to her a couple hours ago, and they're wanting to open her son back up and replace a valve that's inside his heart. And they don't know if he's strong enough to have it or not.
Okay. Remember that request.
He's younger than Johnny.
Okay, remember that request. Anyone else?
Brother Charlie's not feeling well tonight. Also, Sister Carrie, remember her, Sister Cheryl, Brother Larry, Brother Jim Dalton.
They're all sick in the church. Anyone else?
Hey, remember Larry tomorrow. He starts a new job tomorrow evening. So.
Remember that request. Anyone else? Sure, we all got unspoken requests, but let your hand. Open up our handbooks to page
323.
All stand, all simple on there, get around the altar for good evening prayer.
Thank you.
write the question. Anyone else?
They asked church to remember the Toler family. They lost father, husband, uncle. I went to school. His daughter and myself are our best friends from school, and we still are. And I'll be remembering too for travel nurses. We traveled down there to Maine tomorrow for a few months.
Yeah, remember that request. Anyone else? I've got a cousin that needs a prayer. She knows where she's going. I guess they talked to her the other day, said she was ready to go, and she knew where she was going. She just didn't want to leave everybody. But remember her in your prayers. If the Lord don't intervene, she ain't got but much longer. She's full of cancer. Anyone else? All petitions. Everybody ready to take these petitions to the Lord this time. Brother Frank, you want to lead us out?
So, Father, we come to you, Lord, once again. Thank you, Father, as you come. Give you all praise this evening, Lord. No, Father, we have nothing without God this evening. We have nothing without God. Trust in you, Lord, that you'll take care of all things, Lord. Come before you this evening and needs, Lord, upon our hearts, Lord. Dear Lord, those that we're praying for here, the prayer of us, Lord. I pray for them, Lord, that prayers may be answered. Dear Lord, that you may continue to touch and heal those that are sick and afflicted, Lord. Those in the church that's sick, Lord, that you may touch them, Lord. We did pray, Father, for the need of the souls to be saved, Lord. There's many that need God in their lives today. We pray for them, Lord, that you bring conviction upon their hearts, stir their minds, Lord. Help them to come unto you, Lord, and see, Lord, what a wonderful, good God you are. We give you all praise this evening. We pray for the minister tonight, Lord, helping to minister unto our hearts. We thank you, Lord, for all things indeed. We are nothing without them. We love you, Father. Praise your holy name. In Jesus' name, we ask of all things. We all say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Moved over a little bit.
Words will bless us, Solomon.
If you can play it, play it. We got sheet music too.
Well, that bigger part of it.
We need some
voices
up here.
I tried to get him done, but he's got that deep voice.
He'll just sing with us.
That new guy's like,
I guess you'll just play it.
All right. Taught me in
the NG.
Let her in now. I don't know.
Come on.
Here,
you can't call. Come on.
We're singing.
We get fixed in peace.
Jonathan, I'm not pretty yet.
Tell him to come up, Jamie.
We'll take you to Wendy's and buy you a hamburger. How's that?
I got it, Jamie. Tell him. Tell me you've got to come up and sing here with us.
Maybe even a frosty.
Yeah.
Oh, hear that? You either got to come up here and sing with us or sing a solo. Come on, sing one with
us. I'll sing back.
One shot. See if that's a big one.
Harry, not yet.
Ready, Harry?
Yeah.
It should be flat, Harry, okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
Who's going to be first, testimony or song? Amen. Amen. Someone else? Got a testimony or a song on your heart?
I'm going to tell the Lord that I love him.
Amen.
And everything he's ever done to me. He brought me in here to this church. I just shared it to him as a kid. He let me come back. Everybody opened their arms and made my heart feel full. And I'm thankful that he gave that.
Amen.
He said, here, son, you want to save me. And I wasn't saved when I was a kid, but I knew what was right and what was wrong, and I enjoyed it. Every time I get to open that door, he grabs a hold of me, you know, the devil does, and he'll say, you don't need to go down there, just stay home, you know. And I don't do that. And it kills me that every other Sunday now that I got to go to work, and I, you know, I bowed my balls to his face and stuff, and say, you know, this Lord's death. You shouldn't do that.
Yep.
But I'm here.
Amen. Amen. Someone else? Got testimony? Somebody got a song on your heart? You sing it again.
Here, Rich, they paid me not to. I was telling Rich around here they was offering to pay him to sing. I was around here, they paid me not to.
Huh?
Not that one. What are you going to sing? You gonna sing Jesus Loves Me?
Yeah.
All right. Ready?
Yeah.
Jesus loves me, this I know. Where you at, Sloan? Come on. Come on, we'll make a trio. Come on, Sloan. Sing with me and Harry. Hurry. I'll give you a dollar. She's prettier than you are, Rich. That's why I don't offer you 50 cents. You ready to sing, Harry?
Yeah.
You ain't going to sing with us alone? There's too many people, ain't there? Yeah. Is that what it is?
Jesus.
Well, I'm a poor preacher.
Me.
Ready? Yeah. Jesus loves me this I... Now, stand up here.
Me.
Stand up here. You can't sit there like a big dog. Come on. Jesus loves me this I know. For the Bible tells me so, little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. All right, high five. I'll turn it off. You'll turn the channel. It's all right right there. That's the difference in a boy and girl. Sloan stands up here and she sings that song and holds the mic still. And he's looking at it all like this. Let's go with the other one. Me, where you stand, same Jesus that you see taken away shall come again in like manner as you see him taken up into heaven. I can't imagine, Jim, what it was like. These disciples that saw him die, no doubt some maybe even taken off the cross, they knew where he was buried, so somebody watched him be buried. The news came the first day of the week that he's not there. Mary goes and he's not there. She comes back. John and Peter run. He's not there. Two fellows on the road to Damascus said, "We don't understand, you know. Some are saying that he's not there." And all of a sudden, Jesus opens their eyes as he breaks bread. For 40 days, he ascended and descended and was with them in and out at different occasions. And he tells them to go in all the world preaching the gospel, baptizing them in the Father and Son and the Holy Spirit. And as he ends those words, he just a cloud received him out of their sight. What a God. Out of all the different deities that's ever been mentioned and throughout all history, all of the different men that's ever been born to walk up on this earth, he's the only one, Dave, that ever walked out of that grave. I've heard people say that God sent an angel down to wake him up. That ain't true. I've heard people say that God had the angel roll the stone away that Jesus could come out. That ain't true. If he could, when they set up meat, he just appeared before the wall and said, "Peace be still." What a God. And the world that we live in today seemingly wants to just shake their fist at him. And say, "You're weak. You're old. We don't need you. We've got our own thing." That second, that last chorus is, "I'll come again." There ain't no power on earth that can keep me back. I don't know how much you pay attention to the news, but man, Russia is building a mighty army. Gog and Magog. They've got one purpose. They're not telling every world yet, but they've got one purpose. They're coming to Jerusalem to take that land. They will align with Assyria, Iran and Iraq and some of those other Arab nations, Turkey, and they will come from the north. I believe that Korea will come from Korea and China will come from the east. Scripture talks about a nation from the east. I believe they'll come from the east and they'll surround that city and say, "We've got you. We've got you." Knowing that all of the earthquakes that's been taking place, all of the plagues, the stars falling from heaven, the third of the rivers to blood, third of the sea to blood, the third of the trees are burned up, a third of the grass is burned up, all the things that's taken place under those seals and those bulls and those trumpets, they think they've got God by the throat. The Bible tells me that the heavens will open. And he'll come riding on a white horse. Have a name written upon his leg. King of kings and Lord of lords. And will descend upon that army. And the Bible said a sharp sword shall proceed out of his mouth and devour his enemies before him. I've tried to imagine that. I've tried to think that. All right, I'm going to turn the other one on so I can lay this one down. I ain't much at holding mics. But I've tried to think about that. A sharp sword. The Bible tells us today that the Word of God is a sharp, powerful, as a two-edged sword. It's able to divide the bone and the marrow asunder. I'm going to tell you, I have a field dress, I've skinned, I've processed, if you have it, several deer in my life. And I'm telling you, brother, it takes a sharp knife to divide that marrow. I don't have a knife that can cut a bone in half. I can maybe take it, and after a while, if it's sharp enough, and catch it on the right angle, I can cut that sinew loose, or I can cut maybe a cartilage loose. But I've never been able to divide a bone, amen, with my knife. And I've thought about this. How hard does something have to be? And then I begin to realize it's not about how hard it is. It's about how sharp that it is.
There you go.
How sharp. You're talking about on point. It's the Word of God. Everything that we see going on in our society today, amen, listen, that we can describe as far as the world and the way the world is forsaking God. I know, and you know, the Bible said in the last days that there would come scoffers mocking after their own lust. We're there today. People are mocking God after their own lust. I mean, professors, you know, that will stand up and say, hey, amen, listen, you know, people say, you know, if there's a God, let him strike me dead. People are saying stupid things like that. People are trying to tell us that we are the intelligent life. Now, I agree, I understand. When I study the scripture and I go back to Genesis chapter 1, and I begin to think about Adam, the Bible said that every creature that God made, God brought it to Adam, and Adam named that creature. You know what that tells me about Adam? Adam was no dummy. He was very smart. He was very intelligent. And now we've got men that think they're so smart, amen, that they think that there is no God. Amen. I believe with all of my heart that God created the heavens and the earth and all things that are in. But Brother Frank, I can't wrap my head around how someone could believe that we just evolved out of some scum somewhere on some beach. Gary, I can't figure that out. I mean, to me, it would take more faith to believe that than what it does in the creation. To put what I have and everything that I have. Listen, I don't understand. I'm troubled about the world and I know what the Bible says. I know the things, Rich, that it says that must come to pass. But when I see Christians that have faithfully, I realize we got a lot of people that love the Lord that's sick and can't come. Amen. But there's a lot of people that used to stand and praise God and say, I'll never turn my back on him, that never darkened the door of the church. I wonder, do they ever pray? Amen. Listen, I realize, I'm going to tell you something. When you're sitting there and you say, oh God, I need your help. Amen. That's not a prayer, honey. That's a demand and request. Amen. For emergency relief. And I realize when you don't know how to pray, if you're walking where you should walk, the Spirit itself maketh groanings which cannot be uttered today. Amen. But we need prayer lives.
Come on.
Not thank you, God, for this food, amen, and go on. We ought to thank God for our food. We ought to thank God for another day of life, amen. But we need that relationship, and I wonder, not only do they ever, I mean, really pray, not because somebody's sick, not because they have a financial need, but do they ever really talk with God, spend time with God? I really don't have to wonder much about that, because I can tell you something. You spend time with those that you love.
Come on.
Yes. Come on now. Yep. That's just fine to the matter. You don't spend time with those or doing whatever it is that you love. And if you love God like you say you will, honey, you'll be found praising God. You'll be found witnessing for God, telling the good things that God has done for you. And you'll be found sometimes, honey, in a closet, amen, listen, crying out to God, amen, just being thankful. You'll find yourself singing, amen, listen, regardless of what the sun shines or not, you'll have a song. I don't love her just because she fixes breakfast. If I love my wife, and I do, if I love my wife for fixing breakfast, I wouldn't have much love.
my wife will fix me breakfast. You know why? We're not home in the mornings. I mean, even on the weekends. Sometimes we're not home on Saturday mornings. She works every other Saturday, so how can she fix breakfast? Matter of fact, most of the time, most of you know, I'll get up, I'll go in there, and I'll fix her breakfast. Sometimes I fix enough breakfast to send with her as she takes off to work to the girls that are up there, and it brings all smiles. I'm telling you today, friend, you do things for those that you love. And when I see people, again, that used to do all these things for God, and they don't do them anymore, does that mean they still love Him? Well, according to their testimony, well, I still love God. I still believe. There's no fruit behind that. No fruit behind that to back that up. Brother Gary made a statement this morning that I already knew. He said, the Lord has helped me grow so much in the last 2 years. You know how I know that? I don't mean this as a slam. It's a great thing. Brother Gary testifies about every service. Or every service for sure that he's here. He's got something to say for the Lord. And his testimony, brother, they got some backbone. They got some meat to him. Why? He's been spending some time alone with God. Brother Johnny, he's gotten closer to him, honey. He knows who he's talking about today. Rich and Connie been coming here. This is their third week, right? Amen. Finally, I learned Connie's name this week. She got it right. Good. But here's the thing. Amen. The more that I'm around them and the Spirit's bearing witness, amen, that they're my brother. You know what that means? I want to know more about them. I want to spend more time with them. Why? Because it brings joy to my life. Does serving God bring joy to your life? The studying the Word of God. Amen. Listen, as that Bible's laying across the desk or across the lap, and you sit down and you study it. When I get up in the morning, I go in the bathroom, I take my medicine, I get dressed and all those things. But when I come out, you know the first thing that I head for? It's not the refrigerator, regardless of what you think. I grab my Bible, or on my phone, I have three Bible apps, by the way, or two. And there's one that has a place marked. And I start there. And regardless if I get to do anything else, I'm going to spend enough time, I don't care how many verses are in them two chapters, I'm going to read two chapters. Amen, listen, when I get in that truck, amen, listen, I don't reach over and crank the music up. I make sure it's off, and I meditate, and I pray. Honey, from the time I get in to the time I get out, amen, why? Number one, I want to pray for you guys and my family. Number two, amen, I want God to speak back to me. You know, marriage is a two-way thing. Our walk with God is a two-way thing. It's not just us, amen, reaching up and saying, all right, God, this is what I need. Handing him our grocery list, if you'll have it, if fill my buggy up. Let me go home. But sometimes, Brother Jim, those things that we've studied, I thought about the Holy Spirit all week long. Even there on the job. Frank, most of the time he was down on the other floor there this week, and I was up on the second floor this week. We didn't see one another unless he come to aggravate me or it was break time. But he's up there, but I'm thinking and I'm praying, I'm thinking about the scripture. My mind began to think about the Holy Spirit. Amen. Listen, it was there, again there back in Acts chapter 2 and chapter 3. If you don't know it, I've been studying the book of Acts. Amen. And I'm watching what the power of God, when it fell there, everywhere that it showed up, honey, there was an evidence. There was an evidence. What does that mean? I hear so many people talk about the Spirit of God. Amen. And they act like it's the inferior part of the Godhead. Amen. Wrap your head around the fact that the Holy Ghost that lives and dwells in you and I today, it's as much God as what Jesus was. It's as much God as what God the Father was. Honey, they're on a level plane. They're both ageless, or all ageless, all three ageless. They're timeless, and they don't change. A lot of things are changing, but the Holy Spirit is not changing. And when I don't know how to pray,
The Spirit prays for me with groanings that I cannot utter. In other words, in ways that my mind can't fathom is how the Holy Spirit revealed that to me. With groanings that cannot be uttered. With a way. You know, we sometimes when we're around the altar or we're in our car or we're wherever it's at, we feel like we've gotten a hold of God. That Holy Spirit's moving. Tears are rolling down our face. We feel like we've rung the prayer bells of heaven. But I really was it us? Or was it the Holy Spirit ringing them for us? Not only do I have the Holy Spirit praying for me, I've got a high priest at the right hand of God. Amen. You know why he's there, Dave? To make intercession for you and I. Amen. Listen, I'm telling you. So if the Holy Spirit's praying for me, if my Lord is there making intercession for me, they're both interceding. That's what they are. They're both interceding. Listen, with words you and I can't find, with a power that you and I cannot deny today. Amen. Listen, that's why I love that verse, that if God be for us, who can be against us? Honey, God's Son, amen, the Holy Ghost is for me. That means God's for me. He's on my side, Gary. I don't know, this is a little bit different. I didn't read no scripture. I didn't take no text. But it's just what's on my heart tonight. I thought as Brother Bob was preaching there this morning, and I noticed that all of a sudden big tears began to well up on his face as he got in to the part about, amen, spending time with God and what we need to do as Christians today. And I'm telling you, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Brother Gary, I'm telling you, in the flesh, I'm weak. I'm going to admit it, I'm a weak man within myself. But I'm telling you, the Spirit makes us strong. The Spirit helps us make the right decisions, the right choices, to go the right places, to say the right things, to do the right things. That's our guide. That's the job of the Holy Spirit, is to guide us and to lead us in all the paths of truth and righteousness. All. Not some. If I go astray, it's not the Spirit that led me astray, it's Jamie Fortner. I didn't say it was the devil either. We give the devil way too much credit, honey. Oh, he may dangle a little something out there in front of us. Amen. But it still takes these feet or these eyes and these hands to do the wrong thing. The devil cannot make you do anything. Cannot. You did it yourself. He never looked at Adam and Eve and said, you've got to go over and taste of that. He said, hath God said? He put a little doubt in our mind. When I doubt things, when I begin to take the scriptures in my mind and try to twist them and say, well, maybe God meant this. That's not what God means. That's what God said. We've got to understand. Our time's about done. I had lunch with one of my sisters in Columbus Monday. She'll be 49 for her birthday, and she's talking about her bucket list. I ain't got no list. My bucket's full of holes. Everything done leaked out. But we're talking about getting older, and she looked at me and she said, sure beats the alternative. You know what my reply was? I said, does it really? Does it really beat the alternative? I said, do you know where I would be if I died right now? It's where I want to be. With the ones that I long to be with. I love this lady right here, this girl right here. I ain't in no hurry. I love y'all. I ain't in no hurry to leave. Amen. But listen, Brother Johnny, there are times that I get homesick and I just want to be where the Lord's at. Amen, that I don't have to see all the heartache, all the suffering. Amen, to see. I don't know if you folks follow little Addie or not, a little 2.5-year-old girl that they gave her a dose of chemo and it was so strong it destroyed her liver instantly. And this little baby just lays there, yellow as can be. doesn't play much, doesn't cry much. Those, I'm going to tell you something. That breaks my heart. Not because it doesn't just pull on my compassion, honey, it pulls on everything within me, because I know that sin's what caused that. Amen. Listen, I know that there's no good thing in this mortal body. Amen. But I know this, I've got a new one coming. In our Easter play, I play the part of Jesus. You know how many times the devil's told me you ain't worthy to play that? I'm just being honest. See, I shaved it, what beard I was growing there, I shaved it also this week. You know, Ron asked me, he said, well, why did you shave? I said, because I was come closer to playing Santa Claus and I with Jesus, it was so white. I'm just being honest. Time's making a change in me, amen, far as physically. But this one thing I know, my heart is settled. My mind is settled. I know where I'm going. And I will not allow anything to come between me and my Lord. If my wife ever looks at me and says, it's me or Jesus, honey, I want to go on record today. Amen, listen, I love Him first. I don't mean it won't hurt if my wife walks out on me. I realize those things. But my hope is in the Lord. Haven't felt good all day. Even when I got up this morning. Haven't felt good all day. Went out and eat with Michelle. I was going to do some visitation. I just felt so bad after all. I said, I'm going to go home. Went home and went to bed. And I'm telling you, I went straight to sleep. Got up. Got dressed. Ron said, you have to drive to church. I still ain't feeling good. I don't know. But I do know this. The coming of the Lord is at hand. We need to be prepared. We have a revival and a series of meetings scheduled starting next Sunday. We may not be here. Brother Frank and I, Frank keeps... he studies a lot about Jerusalem and the new temple that they're getting ready to build over there. And they've got a peace treaty that they're supposed to roll out. Frank is saying that they're supposed to roll out sometime in April from what he saw there on the internet. You know what that means? If they're signing a peace treaty over there, we better be watching and listening. Because that's who the Lord's coming after. And listen, I'm not trying to put a date. Please, nobody run out here and say, the pastor said that Jesus is coming back April the 16th. That ain't what I said. I'm saying everything is in place. They've got the new high priest picked out. They've got the garments picked out. They're ready to resume service for the Lord. And for them to do that, I've got to leave. I'm not talking about dying. I'm talking about being translated. I love the verse. I don't like much thoughts of dying. I've saw a lot of people die, Jim. It hurts. I don't like those things, those kind of thoughts. But I know the Bible teaches me that some shall not taste of death. They shall be changed. I believe we could very well be the generation that's changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. You've been here 6 years and I've had to preach several funerals out of this church. Wouldn't bother me none enough. I didn't have to preach anymore. And I'm not saying that if you need me, I won't be there. I'm saying I'd just rather us all go up. And I want to say this. If you're not ready, when the trump sounds, you're going to get left.
Amen.
Listen, you don't need a think so. You don't need a maybe so. You need a know so. I know that if that trump would sound right now, I know that I'd drop this old earthly house and it'd raise in the newness just like what same body that Jesus has. Amen. Listen, and I'd be called up into heaven to be with the Lord forever. If you missed the rapture, you'd not missed it all, honey. You just missed the best part, because I'm telling you, all hell is going to break loose. Oh, there'll be peace and safety for a while. Think about this. The economic people are predicting a major crash in the economic system in the next 3 years. A according to things that I read, things that I hear. You realize what would happen if the Christians left this world like that? It's going to throw this world into turmoil. And then all of a sudden, here's going to come a guy with all the answers. The Antichrist. The economic solution, now we're going to all one currency. We'll fix this problem, we'll never have it again. We're going to one currency. We're going to have one world order. We're going to have one religion. We're going to have one government, one religion, one world currency. You know what? You listen at me. You hear me today. You hear me. I don't know how you guys have made professions before. I don't know how you stand today. I don't know how your walk with God is, but I do know this. You know the truth now. And the Bible tells me that them that know the truth and that are left behind, that God will send them strong delusions upon their mind. They'll believe a lie and be damned. Oh, preacher, I'll know the rapture's taking place, and then I'll cry out to God and I'll follow God. If you can't serve God when the Holy Spirit is here in its fullness like it is right now, you'll never serve God. Well, man, listen, during the tribulation period when you got to serve Him because you're about ready to lose everything you got or your head. When they walk up and said, either bow or die, there'll be a lot of them bow. Oh, you trying to scare me? No, I'm trying to warn you. Be ready. The Lord's coming. The Lord is coming. Maranatha, I believe, is the word. The Lord is coming. Are you ready? Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. You ever notice the pictures of Jesus? That His hand is like this in those pictures? You know why? Because if I... Watch. This is what I do with my hand. That's what God wants. Put your hand in His. Let Him lead you. Let Him guide you. He wants to protect you. He wants to love you. I'm not saying everything's easy. Lord knows it's not. He said, in the world ye shall have tribulations. But be of good cheer, I've overcome the world. Again, this morning I thought about Bob as Bob was preaching about the peace of God, which represented the presence of God. You'll never have God's peace until you make peace with God. Do you understand what that means? To make peace with God means that you reconcile things. When two enemies come together and they make peace, they reconcile their differences and they make this alliance to one another that we're not going to argue, we're not going to fight, we're going to work together. That's what we do with God. You see, God will work with you, but you've got to work with Him. God wants to work through us. For every time that we need to be about the Father's business today, revival, again, is a week away. I don't know how much you've been praying, how much you've visited or invited people out to revival, but please be so about the Father's business this week. Susie, come, let's get a song. Sue, did you have a song you was going to sing tonight? Why not? She was looking. You get a song, come on. Get a song, come on. Somebody testify while she gets a song. Maybe you want to pray. Maybe you want to come and thank God for all that He's already done for you. You realize if we just spent the time praising God for what He has already done, we would never have to worry about anything else. Because that's what would happen. Amen. Amen. Come on, fellas, pray with our brothers. Anybody else just want to come and pray? Come on. Scripture says that he knows what we have need of even before we ask. But we have not because we ask not. Yes, Lord, move upon my brother today. Father, unite us together in the spirit and the power of one for the cause of the cross, that your name might be lifted up, might be exalted. Help us as we labor together, God, as a labor of love. How we love you, how we praise you, how we exalt you.
You know best for all of us.
Have your way, Lord. Altar is still open tonight for anybody who needs to pray.
Just suppose that God had searched through heaven and couldn't find one willing to be the supreme sacrifice that was needed.
Anybody else with a song or testimony? Yeah. Don't forget, every night this week, the church will be open at 6:30 for anybody who would want to come and pray.